about the administration's proposal to cut back on legal immigration, maybe by 50%. And there's this new merit-based criteria standard they're thinking of introducing. Here's what she said about it. So when we talk about our ancestors, Kellyanne, I know how proud you are of your family and how proud they are of you for what you've done with opportunity in this country. They broke their backs to provide for you and for me. That promise at the pedestal of the Statue of Liberty are not words just added later, as Stephen Miller suggested at the press conference. They matter. Those were the solemn promise of this country to the world. Not that we just take the best of the best. We take those yearning to be free. You know the words better than I do from the poem,
hey,
The
Chris,
New Colossus.
Also, but you know,
it seems
I know
like
you're
we're changing
some,
that message.
Look, you're giving some sweeping statement about America and patriotism, and I totally agree with American patriotism. It's why I'm here, frankly, serving in the White House. But let's be honest, did you ever get this exercised about the illegal immigrants who were deported many times and had felony convictions that killed people like Kate Steinle? Have you ever felt this impassioned about it? I'm just asking you a question because you act like everyone is the same, and that's not true. And what the senators and the president were saying yesterday is a merit-based immigration system should be considered as a way to make sure that we are keeping wages higher and we're remaining competitive as an American workforce, people who are looking for work.
John, what are you hearing from listeners about this? Because to me, it seems to be a little bit of a strained argument. Forget about the Katie Steinle part of that. That's a very different and discrete issue, and it deserves attention, and it's gotten plenty. But this idea that, well, there's an economic basis for this new standard. Do people buy that? And that as a value judgment, it's time to change or rethink how we consider the promise of this country?
Chris, the real value judgment is to protect middle and low income wage and workers in the United States who have been screwed over and over by this government, who has had policies of shipping their jobs overseas to take advantage of slave cheap labor and bringing immigrants in through H-1B visas or student visas or anything else to take jobs from Americans. The real compassionate issue here is for American workers trying to make ends meet, whose wages haven't gone up and who can't make it. And these policies of immigration that we have is driven by two things. Democrats' desire to get cheap votes and Republicans and the Chamber of Commerce desire to get cheap labor. That is screwing the American worker. I don't know how more blunt to say it. The policy of Donald Trump here, which, by the way, is the same almost that Australia has, the country that all of a sudden Joe Madison is holding up as the lighting image, same policy that they have. What he is saying is, look, we're going to, for the first time in 40 years, we're going to prioritize Americans and the American worker.
All right, Joe.
That's the difference.
Let me tell you something. You know, let me talk about my ancestors. You didn't give a damn what language they spoke when you grabbed them from West Africa and from East Africa and brought them here. You didn't even help them speak English. You brought them here for cheap labor. If you really want to talk about labor, let's talk about what's happening in Canton, Mississippi right now, where they won't even allow workers to even have union representation. So if you really want to put Americans to work, pay them a livable wage. Let's see what Donald Trump thinks about a $15 an hour job. And I guarantee you, if you pay people a livable wage, they'll do the work and you won't have to worry about it. But here's the other thing. What do you say to people who come from countries where there are civil wars? Do you have to tell a child, a mother, somebody who's leaving a civil war or leaving starvation, look, you can't come to America because you can't speak English? That's not the America that I live in.
All right, John and Joe, I appreciate this. This was a robust conversation.
Thanks,
you made CNN tonight better. Thank you, fellas.